thought I'd try to do the most boring video on the internet. And this is my attempt. So yes, this is going to be very boring. So what am I going to, do? I had this Waterman Filius, and it has, you know, a little bit of sheen to it, shine. It looks nice. But there are some little scratches all over it. So what I'm going to try to do is use micro mesh and Anderson micro gloss, Anderson pens micro gloss, to just smooth out some of those scratches and add a bit more depth to the finish. After this, I'm not going to say anything. So here goes, the most boring video on the internet. This stuff will strip metal plating, gold plating, so be careful when you're doing something like this not to go over the gold. Okay, so. Don't know if you can see it on the camera, but it does in person look just a little deeper in the blue marbling. Now there were some small scratches there, and I started off with 12,000. If there are deeper, or if you really want to get it smooth, I would probably start off with a couple different micro meshes. Say 3,500, then you go to 8,000, and then you go to 12,000. But I just want to go to 12,000 just to kind of give you an idea what's going on here. And that actually took some of the scratches out. There's still a few little micro scratches in there. I started off with number five micro gloss. Anderson Pens is the seller of this, and you know this is hell. It has a, it's just a material that has some abrasive elements to it, and it will slowly sort of smooth down the surface, sanding and polishing. Then I finished with number one, and I used a micro cloth just as I polished it. Now, you have to be careful, especially with gold-plated elements of your pens. So just don't polish over those. And I think that looks better. It's hard to see in the camera, but it just has a little bit more depth, a little bit more life to it. Now, if I wanted to get it very, very smooth, very, very shiny, like I said, I would start with 3,500 grit, 8,000 grit, and then 12,000 grit. This is micro mesh that I used. It's a good product. Now, this is not a professional, but in any means, video. I'm just doing showing you what I do and how to use the material. Everybody has different methods, and you also have to be aware you can actually take too much material off as you polish a pen. And some pens like celluloids, I wouldn't touch. Right, this is just a blue plastic. It's good for plastic and resins and things like that. The more expensive the pen, of course, don't do this if unless you just want to. That's up to you. But this is just me as a hobbyist wanting to touch up a pen, clean it up a little bit, give it a little bit more depth to the finish. And then I'm as you just go, you polish it up a bit more, and you're looking through the layer of the gloss, and it just gives it a little bit more life, a little bit more pizzazz. And for me, I like old pens, and sometimes they come to you in odd conditions, like you might, the previous owner might have been a biter, chewing on the pen. So you can actually, in some instances, get rid of bite marks and things like that. You might have to fill them in using a bit of crazy glue, and then sand that down, and then add more, gloss medium, gloss polishing mediums to it. And it takes a little longer than I'm showing you here. The black here, I didn't really do, but that's fine. I don't think you can really tell on the camera. It just has a bit more life. And this is the most boring video on the internet. I am pretty sure it is. And if you hated it, I hope you give it a thumbs up. If you loved it, give it a thumbs up. And how do you polish your pens? Let me know in the comments. Everybody has a different approach, I know. And like I said, this is not a professional example of how to do it, but as a hobbyist and you're wanting to fix something up, these are materials that I use. And that's the fun part about fountain pens. I know I said I wasn't going to talk in the video, but I thought I should, just to give you a little disclaimer at the end here. But this is the fun thing about being in the hobby, tinkering with your fountain pens, learning how to fix them up a little bit. Things like that, especially if you're using older pens. This is a Filius from the late 90s, early 2000s, and I'll do a video about it sometime. But anyway, I hope you're having a great day, and I'll see you soon. Bye bye.